to discuss it about the seal. And I mentioned the seal with the start of Pteridophyta, where vascular bundles are first seen. And seal is also started in the plant anatomy. So here we'll be discussing about the seal. And one thing you can get assured with that, once you watch this video completely, after that, all the questions asked from this topic will be definitely solved by you. Now, here we'll be discussing about different types of the seal, examples included, and I'll be even telling you what are the important examples which are asked in the exams also. So guys, seal is actually the systematic or organized arrangement of vascular bundles. Vascular bundles means we're talking about the xylem and phloem. So seal is actually forming the central part of the plant. So if I say that this is the cross section or transverse section of a plant body, then in the central part, what is present over there? In the central part, they have this pith present. Now, different types of pith are there on the basis of these vascular tissues arrangement, but they'll be always forming the central part. Clear? So the seal consists of three main parts. First one is pericycle, means the pericycle is forming the outermost layer of this seal. And one thing, make this thing very sure that this is one important point from which questions are asked. And usually students get confused between pericycle and endodermis. So remember, the outermost part of the seal is pericycle, or we can say that the seal starts with the pericycle. Inside the pericycle, vascular bundles are there, that is the xylem and phloem are present. And then they have the last part, that is pith also. Now, pith can be present in the seal or can be absent in the seal. It's not necessary for the seals to have pith in them. Now, outside the seal, the tissue present in the plants is endodermis. So, as you can see, this black colored part I marked as the seal. Outside this black colored part, they will have this layer that is endodermis. So, endodermis is actually the innermost part of the cortex layer. And about these different layers, tissue layers in the plants, we'll be discussing in plant anatomy. So we can say that seal is a central vascular cylinder with or without the pith. Okay, like this we can easily define the seal. What we'll say to define the seal? Seal is a central vascular cylinder with or without the pith. It starts with the pericycle, and on the outside the seal, what is present? The innermost layer of the cortex, that is endodermis. So, from the introductory part of the seal, these are the points from which the questions are possible. Now, let's see the classification of the seal. And the seal is basically divided into six types. And the most primitive one we have got is protosteel. And then we have got siphonosteel, solenosteel, dictyosteel, eusteel, and atactosteel. Here in this video, I'll be telling you about all these types of the seal, plus the evolution of the seal also, like which seal got evolved from which type of seal. So evolution we'll study at the last, so that we'll be knowing what these seals are. And so now let's get started. The first one we have is protosteel. This protosteel is the most primitive type of seal. Means when the evolution of the seal started, means for the first time in pteridophytes, vascular bundles are found. And we have seen the seal formation in the this pteridophyta. So they have the most primitive type of the seal, that is known as protosteel. So it is most primitive type. Most primitive type, first evolved type of the seal. This protosteel is given more names, that is monosteel, or it is also known as solid steel. So these a few more names of the protostele, and this protostele is formed by a solid mass of xylem which is surrounded by the phloem. So inside xylem will be there, the solid mass, and outside phloem will be there. Now if the xylem is solid inside, it means that pith is absent in the protostele. Pith absent. So in the pteridophyta members, in their stele, what is absent? Pith is absent. This protostele is further classified into four types, that is haplostele, actinostele, plactostele, and mixed protostele. And this classification is done on the basis of shape of xylem, on basis of xylem shape. Different shapes of the xylem are there, on according to which this classification is actually given. So now let's see this types of the protostele. The first one we have got is haplostele, and the examples is Rhynia and Selaginella. So guys, this haplostele is the most primitive type, simplest type of the stele, which is a type of protostele. In this you can see that in a ring form, phloem is present on the outer side and solid xylem is present on the inner side. Both are present in the form of ring. No pith formation is there. Now, the next type we have got is actinostele. This actinostele is found in the members like Psilotum, Lycopodium, Isoetes, and these actinosteles look like this, where phloem is present in a ring form and a star-shaped xylem is present. The characteristic feature of the actinostele is the presence of a star-shaped xylem found in Psilotum, Lycopodium, and Isoetes. Next, the third type we have got is plectostele. This plectostele has the xylem in the form of plates. As you can see, these yellow-colored structures are the plates which are representing these xylem. And hence the name given plectostele. Plecto means plate-like steles will be there, found in the species of Lycopodium. That is, example, we have Lycopodium clavatum. Then we have the next type of protostele, that is mixed protostele. Now here you can easily say that what this type of stele will be and what is the shape of the xylems will be. So mixed protostele means the xylem will be present in the form of circular patches. As you can see over here, four xylem patches are there, which are present in between the phloem. Such type of mixed protostele is found in Lycopodium species like Lycopodium serenum. So this is all about the first type of stele, that is protostele, and now we have the second type of stele, that is siphonostele. Now siphonostele is a type of stele in which pith is present, and now you can see that the central part, this one, is a complete pith. Just a minute. So the central part is a complete pith formed here in this part diagram also, and here also. This is what? This is pith. So centrally, pith is present in these individuals, and then these siphonostele are further classified into two groups. The first one we have got is ectophloic siphonostele. And the examples are very, very important. Questions are asked on this ectophloic siphonostele. So I'll just give them 2 stars since they are important. Here what is happening? Inside pith is there. Then outside pith, what is there? Xylem. And the outermost ring is formed by the phloem. Now, whereas here in the case of empty phloic siphonostele, what is happening over here? Here the xylem is actually surrounded by the layer of phloem on both the sides. So here on the inner side also, as you can see, I'm marking with the pink color. This pink color is representing the another ring of phloem which is present on the inner side of the xylem. So now if we label it, this is phloem, this is xylem, and again phloem layer will be there in the form of a complete ring. The innermost part is the spathe, and this forms a complete structure of the seed. And the type of steel is known as amphiphloic steel, found in the members of Pteridophyta like Edianthem and Marsilia. And again, two stars, because questions are asked on this type of examples. So the siphonosteel is one of the important part of the steel from which the questions are actually asked. Now let's move to the next type of the steel we have got. That is solenosteel. So in this solenosteel, the characteristic feature is the presence of this horseshoe-shaped steel with one leaf gap. Now, it can be ectofluic or amphifluic also. So guys, here what is there? This outer one will be the phloem. I'll change the color so that you can easily see. So this outer side phloem will be there, and on the inner side xylem is there, and this complete horseshoe shaped structure is the seed, right? So such type of steel is found in solenosteel, and this is one characteristic point of the steel. It has this leaf gap present in it. Clear? It can be ectofluic or it can be this amphifluic also, that is the xylem present on the inner side and phloem on the outer side like this. I'll show you. This is xylem and this red colored layer is phloem. Either horseshoe shaped structure like this, or another possibility is there that phloem is present, then they have this xylem present on the inner side in the form of horseshoe itself, and again they have this phloem present in the form of horseshoe in the inner side. So both ectofluic and amphifluic type of solenosteel is possible in these members. Now the next one we have got is the fourth type, that is dictyosteel. So dictyosteel is also found in the members of Pteridophyta, and here they are found in the advanced pteridophytes, most evolved pteridophyta members like the Pteridium teres and Dryopteris. So three examples are there in which the dictyosteel is found. In such type of steel, we can say it is a type of siphonosteel in which the main vascular cylinder will break into many fragments due to many leaf gaps. So these black colored structures are actually the leaf gaps due to which the vascular bundles are actually formed into the pieces. So it is a evolved form of siphonosteel itself, and it is broken into fragments because of these leaf gap present. Clear? Now, next point is that each divided fragment is known as meristeel. So this is one fragment, this one fragment of the vascular bundles is known as meristeel, and this is going to have its own separate endodermis and pericycle. Now, this point is important, that is, what is meristeel? So meristeel is a fragment of the siphonosteel which has the vascular cylinder along with its own pericycle and endodermis also. Clear? Now, this here, the pith is absent in the case of single meristeel. As you can see, this is one single meristeel, right? So there is no pith present. So we can say in one single meristeel, pith is absent. Pith absent. So these are characteristic features of the dictyosteel, which you need to remember along with the examples. Next, the number five type of steel we have got is used steel. Number five. And this used steel is found in the plant groups like gymnosperms and dicots. These dicots are the members of the angiosperms. Dicots belongs to angiosperms. Actually, angiosperms are classified into two, dicotyledons and monocotyledon. So, dicotyledon normally known as dicots, and they have this type of steel present in them. Now, here in case of used steel, the vascular bundles are arranged in form of ring. So, vascular bundles in ring, they are arranged as you can see here. In between these vascular bundles, these black structures are the medullary rays. No leaf gaps are there, but here what is present? Medullary rays are there. In plant anatomy, you see the transverse section of the dicots and monocots, and you will see these medullary gaps over there. In between medullary gaps, you can see this yellow structures, and these yellow structures are actually the vascular bundles. That is xylem and phloem is present. These vascular bundles are arranged in the form of ring, as you can see. And now we have the most advanced type of the steel, that is atectosteel. So in this atectosteel, this is found in the case of the members of monocots. So we can say that the monocots are the most advanced one, and this point I discussed in the classification chapter, right, if you remember. So here in the atectosteel, what is happening? The vascular bundles are completely distributed in the ground tissue. Means there is no endodermis, no pericycle present here. And it is highly developed type of the steel. Seen in the members of the monocots. So we can say that here no endodermis, no pericycle, and the vascular bundles. You can see these triangular structures are actually the vascular bundles, which are spread in the ground tissue completely. Now, in detail about the tissues, we'll see in plant anatomy. But the type of steels are clear and the examples are clear mainly. Atectosteel is found in the monocots. Some of the dicot members do have this atectosteel, but the details we are not discussing here. We'll discuss them in the anatomy chapter. So this is all about the different type of steels we have got here with us. And now the last part we have, that is the evolution of the different types of steels. So the most primitive one we have got is what? The most primitive one we have is protosteel. Protosteel. Now, from this protosteel, three types of steels got evolved. Number one is actinosteel. Even though the questions on evolution are not asked, but for your knowledge, so that you will not get confused, I'm just telling about this complete evolutionary sequence. Then another one is amphifluid siphonosteel got evolved. Amphifluid siphonosteel, and another one we have is ectofluid siphonosteel. Ectofluid siphonosteel. Clear? Now, after this, actinosteel got evolved into the another type of steel, that is plectosteel. So from actinosteel, the next type of steel we got is plectosteel. Those plate shaped xylems were there, right? So plectosteel got evolved from the actinosteel, whereas the amphifluid siphonosteel got evolved into dictyosteel. Ectosteel, and the ectofluid siphonosteel got evolved into solenosteel. It got evolved into solenosteel. Clear? Now, this solenosteel got further evolved into the more advanced type of steel, that is U steel. Okay, and the U steel got evolved into the most advanced one, that is A tacto steel. So guys, this is one complete evolutionary sequence, and make sure that you learn the examples, the important characters which I told you of different types of the steel. If you have learned this complete part, 100% guarantee there is no other question asked from this portion or this topic. So if you like this video, please like my video and subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed it yet. And do share with your friends so that your friends will also get to know about these videos. They can also learn very well.